On September 23, 2017, OSHA reduced the permissible exposure limit for respirable crystalline silica. Here are four reasons why you should care. Crystalline silica is a common mineral that is found in a variety of building materials, especially concrete. Cutting into these materials creates a lot of fine dust and something called respirable crystalline silica, which is extremely hazardous to your health. When you breathe in respirable crystalline silica, the microscopic particles go deep into the lung tissue, causing permanent damage and a buildup of scar tissue. Even after you leave the job site and are no longer exposed, the damage keeps progressing and getting worse. Silica-related diseases are serious and deadly. These diseases include silicosis, lung cancer, kidney disease, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease or COPD, even tuberculosis infections due to a compromised immune system. Most of these diseases have no specific treatment or cure. Symptoms don't show up for weeks, months, years, or even decades after exposure. OSHA estimates that around 2 million workers are exposed to respirable crystalline silica each year, and around 840,000 of them at levels above the current standards. So, from a public health point of view, this is a big deal. OSHA has beefed up the fines for violations. Current maximum penalties range from over $12,400 per violation to more than $124,000 for willful or repeated violations. No business can afford to be throwing money away on expensive OSHA fines. It is simply far less expensive to just make sure you're compliant. The biggest financial threat to your business isn't fines from OSHA, it's expensive lawsuits. The very last thing you want is to find out 10 years from now that a former employee is suing you because they're sick. These types of lawsuits are hard to fight and can cripple your business. An attorney will ask if you followed Table 1 of the standard, if you provided respiratory protection, if you provided medical exams, and he'll also ask for proof that you did. Even if you win the case, you'll still lose because you'll have spent thousands of dollars on your own defense, plus hours and hours of your time. It is far better to comply with the standard and protect your employees from getting sick, rather than risk future litigation. Complying with the new silica standard can also be really good for your business. Most general contractors are requiring their subs to be trained and get compliant with the new standard before they'll hire them for a job. So if you can show your GC that your people are trained, your records are in order, and you have the required equipment, you'll have a big advantage over your competition. That means more jobs, more business, and more money in your pocket. The new standards are complicated and have several areas of compliance. From equipment and respirators to medical exams and training, it can be a bit overwhelming. The experts at Jon-Don are here to help. We can help guide you through the standard, make sure you've got the right equipment, so you can ensure your job sites are safe and compliant. Just visit www.jondon.com/silica or call 800-556-6366 to speak with a concrete specialist today.